other strands of the whip. So when this whip comes down on the back of a person, as you can understand, it digs deeply into the body. This whip would have lacerated veins and arteries, and even the kidneys and vital organs could be exposed and slashed. A horrible, horrible process to be whipped by the Romans. And Jesus was whipped 40 times minus one. They held back one out of mercy. So 39 times this whip came on the back of Jesus Christ. Listen, some people died from the scourging alone. It was described in that day as a halfway crucifixion. That's how bad it was. And we wonder, why did Jesus have to suffer like that? I understand maybe that Jesus had to be nailed to a cross because that was prophesied, but why did he have to suffer? Well, he did suffer. We follow a suffering Savior. Isaiah 53 gives us description of what Christ went through. He's despised and rejected by men, a man of sorrows and acquainted with grief. He has borne our grief and carried our sorrows, yet we have seen him stricken, smitten by God, and afflicted. But listen, the answer is now given. Why did he suffer? He was wounded for our transgressions. He was crushed for our iniquities. The punishment for our peace was upon him, and by his stripes we are healed. You see, Jesus voluntarily suffered in our place. It's hard for us to think of a perfect creator going through something as human as pain and suffering. But I want you to know something. God has suffered more deeply than anyone could imagine. Jesus is called a man of sorrows. But why did he suffer? Why did he die? Simple answer. Because he loved and he loves. He loved the people he was dying for, and he loves you. And this also means that he can enter into your suffering as well. Am I speaking to someone right now who is suffering? Maybe you're in a hospital bed. Maybe you're in a wheelchair. Maybe you're in a state of personal anguish. Maybe you're mourning the death of a loved one. Maybe there's just something that's causing you so much pain. God can enter into your suffering with you, and he cares and he understands. You're not alone in your suffering today. Jesus has been there. He's walked in your shoes, and he's here for you. Hebrews 2:17 tells us he himself has gone through suffering, and because of that, he is able to help us when we're being tempted. So don't think that God's up in heaven disconnected from what you're facing. Jesus has faced it. He's experienced it. He suffered. Now, after Christ has been whipped with a Roman cat of nine tails, Pilate brings Christ out before the bloodthirsty people, and he says, "Ecce homo," which means, "Behold the man." In other words, look at this guy. Has he suffered enough? Is there enough blood for you? Can I let him go now? Oh, no, they're not satisfied. They still want more. They want his death by crucifixion. They say, "Crucify him and let his blood be on us and on our children." We read that Pilate then washes his hands in a basin, sort of in a symbolic way, saying, "I'm done. I've done everything I could to free this man. I wash my hands of the matter." But listen, you can't wash your hands of Jesus Christ. One historical account tells us that within 7 years of this event, Pontius Pilate was removed from office. He was left broken, destitute, unwanted by Caesar, and all alone. And we also hear from history that he went out in the darkness of night and, like Judas Iscariot, hung himself. See, here was Pilate's problem. He knew Jesus was innocent. He may have even known Jesus was God. But he cared more about what people thought than what Jesus thought. And his craving for popularity and power cost him everything. Listen, don't let a fickle crowd show you how to think. It could cost you everything as well. Now Jesus is led off to be crucified. Matthew's gospel tells us that he was surrounded by a whole garrison of Roman soldiers. This was a lot, upwards of 600 of them. And by the way, they were the elite legionnaires. The legionnaires were sort of the cream of the crop of the Roman army. Modern equivalent would be the Green Berets or Delta Force or Navy SEALs. And as they saw how much Jesus had suffered, how his back had been ripped open and a tremendous loss of blood, you would have thought that they would have had sympathy. Sadly, it's the very opposite. Mark 15, verse 17 says, they put a purple robe on him, by the way. Purple was the color of royalty. So they're mocking the fact that he is supposed to be a king. They put a purple robe on him and twisted together a crown of thorns and set it on him and began to call out, "Hail, the King of the Jews!" And again, they struck him on the head with a staff and they spit on him. And falling on their knees, they paid homage to him. It was all done in mockery. These people literally spit in the face of God. And then they take this crown of thorns.